Hi, I'm Simon from the Red Ferret, and before we start this video, I want to ask you to subscribe and click that bell button down below to stay updated on our latest, greatest, most awesome content on the space of YouTube. Let's get cracking with the video. So in front of me, I have the Alphawise U33, the printer. And I'm going to start off by being honest. I knew nothing about 3D printers when I got this from GearBest. So I thought maybe this can be my perfect first 3D printer for me. And it actually is. I'm going to explain why. So it comes in a box, as you can see here, that's not really advertised or something. So you get all the components and you have to install the printer yourself. In the box you get a piece of paper that guides you through the different steps, but don't use this. This is very difficult with the paper. I watched a complete video of about 40 minutes, I think, to install this thing, and I'm going to link that video. It's a great video. I used it to install this and it worked perfectly fine. However, there was one thing that didn't work. So I installed everything, I booted it up, and I wanted to heat the bed up, and it didn't heat up. Nothing happened. This didn't get warm, and I was like, oh no, what's happening? And I checked, and there was a connector not connected down below, somewhere over here. So, no major issue, but if you wouldn't notice it, then it wouldn't work and you'll have to send it back. So, if you have that problem, check your connectors. So, the 3D printer itself is not that big. As you can see, it's a standard size, mostly. One main thing I'm already going to say is that there is no filament. There is a bit of filament, like white filament, I think 1 meter at max, and that's really not enough to print something. So, I had to buy this extra filament. That's like $20, so it's not that expensive, but hey, there is no filament included, so make sure you have your own filament. So for people who are new, if you want to print something in 3D, you have a very small micro SD card over here. You get a USB stick in the box, which you can plug in your micro SD card, and then you plug your USB in your computer and you use software to put a 3D print on this card, and then you can read it over here on the Alphawise touchscreen. What software do I use? I use Cura. This is also included, .exe, so it's for Windows. I have a Mac, so I had to download Cura, but hey, it's for free. It's awesome. You find the Alphawise U20 in one of the printer settings in the Cura. You have to change the parameters a bit to change it to the U30. So the size of the print bed is the same as the one, as the U30 at least. That's over here. I was a bit hesitant to print things because I was like, ooh, this is hot and all that stuff and that's not going to work and I have no idea how it works, and it's actually pretty easy. I go to Makerverse or Printerverse, I don't know what's it called again, I'm going to link it below as well. And there you can find everything you want. You can of course create your own things. I have not done that yet, so don't ask me how. I've not done that yet, but I've downloaded different things like Darth Vader, for example, Pikachu, for example, a stand for my MacBook as well. And you can just print this here and it works. It's amazing. I find it crazy how you can take something from your computer, plug it in here, click a couple of buttons, go away, and after 2 hours, 3 hours, it's printed. That's so cool. Yes, but I had some problems at the start with calibration. So you need to get your printer bed straight and the nozzle, so where the red thing over here is coming from, has to be close enough in order to put the filament the right way on the print bed. So if it's too high, for example, it will slide. If it's too close, it will start to bend because it's too hot, for example. So you have to take a lot of things into consideration when you print something, and you need to level out your bed as well. There are a lot of tutorials online how you do this, but I found something, or I saw a video where your printer has to print out different pieces, and on these pieces you can see if your printer is lined out correctly or your print bed. So if everything is close enough, as you can see here, so there are no lines in here, then it's good. So the right one was good, the middle one as well, but this one already, you can see I can put my finger through here. So that's not good. This one as well, also seeing through, and this one as well. So those were not good, and that meant that I had to put the print bed a little higher and closer to the nozzle. Overall, it's mostly learning. At the start, you do a lot of things. You try to print a lot of things And some things work and others don't, like this for example. This had to be something which, like a fidget thing that you have to turn over here and then everything spins. But I think something happened and it was printed the wrong way, as you can see over here. So something happened here. I don't know what, and I didn't try it again, but you have these supports, so you can fill in Cura if you want supports or not. I always use supports, because that's safer. But you have to take off these supports, and as you can see, all this debris, all this stuff over here, those are all supports. So I really hate taking off supports, but hey, they're necessary, because I tried printing a Pikachu over here without supports, and as you can see, it hangs over a little bit because it doesn't have any support over here, and it started breaking immediately. So you really have to get support. And then this one, for example, this was going to be a Pikachu, as you can see, but it failed somewhere over here. I don't know why. Maybe because it's the print I downloaded. Maybe something happened here. I don't know, but it failed. Okay, not everything fails, by the way. This is really a very good printer for someone who wants to start 3D printing. This is awesome. Like, for real, I was very excited to check this out. I'm really glad I did. So what did I print? Some small things. So this is Darth Vader, as you can see. I've printed it very small. This took about half an hour to print with supports. So still, for something this size, half an hour, that's like the standard time. Look at this. This is actually pretty cool. They're pretty cool. And then I also printed a small dragon. This is very, very small. It's like the dragon from Daenerys Targaryen, yeah. But the first thing I actually printed, I was so excited about, were these feet for my MacBook Pro. So I had to print four of these. So these small parts, and then you get all these small parts, you have to put them in this these big things, like I don't know, it's like a bridge or something, like two of these big things. And it took me about, I think the small ones were about 20 minutes, so it took me about full day to print everything. And what is it for? Well, as you can see, it's a stand for your MacBook, so it's pretty cool. It works great, as you can see. So that's really awesome. I like that, and that's actually why I got sent this printer for things like this. I really like 3D printing because you can print off things that are useful. If you want to buy this, of course it will look maybe a bit better or different. You'll pay about, I think, $20 for an Apple product or for something that has to support an Apple product, while you can just make it on your printer, which is awesome. So, but the printer itself has two printing beds. As you can see here, I chose the glass plate, but if you take this off, you have a black plate as well, which is some kind of thermal heating plate, not glass. But I really like the glass because it's way more easy to get your prints off. On the other side of this, on the black side, they stick very, very hard to the black side, and I really have to pull them and scrape them off, and I really don't like it because I'm damaging it that way, so that's not that good. So I'm just going to turn this on so you can see that. Maybe you've already seen it in other videos, so let's check it out. So over here you have move ahead. You can move everything if you want it. You can put everything to the home, as you can see, so it works perfectly fine, no issues with that. And then you get your files over here. So if I press this, I get all my files. So Pikachu, for example, V2, Vader G-code, Dragon G-code. There are some standard files on here as well that you can test out. But I've put mine in here, and then you press open, you start printing. Then it heats up the nozzle, it heats up the printing bed, and it starts printing. So 14 minutes, but with support it will take longer, of course. You can also extrude material, you can preheat recovery more. And in the more section you have the bed leveling, which is great. So this way you can press this side, for example, and everything will go to this side. So that means you can level out this part of the print bed. So that's great. That's an automatic helper. So as I have said, I have been using this printer for about 2 weeks now, and I've printed several things, I've tried several things, and I have to say, this is an awesome piece of hardware. I really love this printer, and I'm just blown away by the fact that you can print something that's on your computer. Like, it's fictional, it's It's virtual over there and then it's physical over here. That's so crazy. I really think that's crazy. And the Alphawise U30, if you're really looking for a good printer for a good price, because this is an amazing price. I think 200 euros or something like that, you really can't go wrong. This is an amazing printer, although you have to install it yourself and you have to tweak it a little bit and all that stuff, but that's with every printer like that. And of course, you also pay that in the price. So, would I recommend this printer? Hell yeah, this is an awesome printer. And I really enjoy making things with this. And if you have any questions about this printer, any remarks about this video, let me know. I'll be glad to help you with more information about this. Because I didn't show printing, of course, because printing is like 20 to 30 minutes or more. But that depends, of course, on what you want to print. I started out as a noob in 3D printing, and after about 2 weeks, I can say that I fully understand how it works. Most of the time, I fully understand how it works. It's very easy, and you really don't be scared to try things, because I did, and I'm glad I did. I've learned a lot about 3D printing with this printer, and it's an awesome piece of hardware. Alright, if you have any questions, let them know in the comment section down below, and I'll be very, very glad to help you. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like down below. If you didn't, leave a dislike and tell us why, so we can improve our videos. I hope I'll see you, yes, you who's watching this behind your phone or behind your computer screen, yeah, it's like that, in our next video. Bye-bye.